Welcome everybody to my talk about a journey into ontology approximation from non-horn to horn. This is a joint work with Carsten Lutz, Johannes Marti and Frank Walter, and my name is Annika Hager. Let me start with a little bit of a motivation. So why are we doing what we are doing? We are talking about ontology approximation, which is a frequent operation in practice. So imagine you're constructing an ontology, then you choose a language for your ontology, which is often a description logic, which is suitable for the actual purpose you are working on. And in practice, you often wish to reuse knowledge which is already entailed in other ontologies. So we have on the other side, ontologies contains these information formulated in a different language. And ontology approximation is now when we have the one side, the source ontology here, notated as OS for source, formulated in the source language, and we now translate this ontology into our chosen target language in our target ontology. This translation is ontology approximation. In practice, this is often done in ad hoc way by simply dropping all subconcepts that involve a constructor which is not supported by our chosen target language. And doing it that way, there's no understanding of the information loss that goes on, and that isn't a very good approach. So when we say ontology approximation, we mean roughly spoken something like this. So ontology OT, target ontology, formulated in our target language LT, is an approximation of our source ontology if our target ontology has the same LT consequences as our source ontology. And LT consequences mean something like concept inclusion, role inclusions, or whatever else is expressible in our chosen target language. Okay, so let us have a quick look why the naive approach is incomplete. I brought you a little example. Consider the ELU ontology. So our source language is ELU, which is EL with disjunctions. And in our source ontology, we have two concept inclusions. Then the naive approach is we wish to translate it into an EL approximation or make an EL approximation. So we have a target ontology formulated in EL. Then our naive approach is simply get rid of the one disjunction. And so we only get the second concept inclusion from our source ontology, and that is the only inclusion in our target ontology. Fair enough, that is one kind of an approximation, okay, but it isn't complete. And what do we mean by complete? As I mentioned before, there are consequences of our source ontology, EL consequences, which are expressible in our target language, which is EL as well. And one example for this is this second concept inclusion. Why is it a consequence? When we have exist job to job, then we can see that by the first concept inclusion in our source ontology, we have the disjunction main job or side job. And the question is, what is the consequence of this disjunction? So regardless if we are choosing main job or side job, is there something that have both in common? And indeed it is, because main job is main job, and when we choose side job, we have exist job. So side job, exist job, side job, and can use the second concept inclusion, getting exist job, main job, and part-time job. And now we have exist job, main job on both sides. And so this is an EL consequence, which we can express in our target ontology as well. And the same is true for this third new concept inclusion as well. And with this three concept inclusions, this is now what we would call a complete EL approximation of this given source ontology. So what can we learn from this naive approach or from this example are two things. First, okay, so the naive approach is incomplete and isn't a very good one. And the second one is that even for such simple example like this, the EL consequences are non-obvious most of the time. And for the rest of the talk, I will give you a little bit more of an overview to the ELU-EL approximation case, which is a basic case of our paper. And at the end, I give you an overview of the rest we have done in this paper as well. Okay, so before I can show you our ELU-EL approximation scheme, I need to mention two observations we made during our work. The first observation is that projective approximations are more powerful than non-projective ones. So what are projective approximations? Projective approximation mean we allow to introduce new fresh symbols during the approximation. And from now on, when I'm speaking about approximations, I always mean projective ontology approximations. And the second observation we made is that finite approximation need not to exist, also in the projective case. And even bound depth approximations can get very large. And the reason why, you can find a discussion in our paper with a few examples. And I don't have enough time to get you in too much detail, but this observation leads to a new term we need to introduce to make sure that our approximation is finite. And this new term is so-called OS generatable. Okay, so what does OS generatable mean? We can call an EL concept C OS generatable if there is in our set of subconcepts of our source ontology a term like exists RD, such that this exists RD occurs on the right hand side of a concept inclusion in our source ontology. Okay, and we can take this D and find a concept inclusion like this, such that our source ontology models this concept inclusion. And then the C is OS generatable. So OS generatable concepts are concepts which are generated by our source ontology. Okay, so on the next slide, you will see our ELU-EL approximation scheme. Please don't read it. I will show you the important parts and explain the effects with an example. So please don't read the whole slide. It's a lot. For the moment, only you need to notice here the second bullet point saying something about the concept G, and saying that G is an EL concept, which is OS generatable, and that the depth of F and the depth of G must fulfill the chosen depth bound. Okay, and now we get to our example, which we already seen, and can look what our approximation scheme would made with our example. So we knew that this is our complete approximation, so maybe we should start and just look, would we get these three lines from our approximation scheme as well? And the answer is yes, because the first line here is as a result of our first line here. This first line simply make sure that we take as much as possible from the original structure of our source ontology, as long as it's not inside the scope of the operators we can't express in our target language. And the second and third line are consequences of the fourth line here. And with this knowledge, we also can say that main job and the concept, main job and part-time concept are so-called OS generatable in this example. Okay, the story doesn't end here because our approximation scheme would produce much more than these three lines. And the reason for this are two kinds, because the first one is this isn't the complete approximation scheme. I let out one little thing, and this little thing are these up arrows which occur here now. And what does these up arrows mean? These up arrows mean that we have a projective part in our approximation. So our first line would produce something like job. And here have you X, main job or side job. Why? Because we have this first concept inclusion in our source ontology. And for the concept inclusions in our source ontology in the first line, we say, okay, we have here DNF normal form already, so DNF doesn't change anything, but up arrow means we rewrite every disjunction, every outermost disjunction with a new fresh symbol called X. So we have here the disjunction main job or side job, and we introduce a new fresh symbol X, main job or side job, and put this new found concept inclusion into the ontology as well. And our approximation scheme would produce many, many more of such concept inclusions. A few don't deliver any new knowledge, something like this, X main job or side job, yeah, and on the other side, main job or side job as well. Okay, but as you can see here, our approximation scheme produces all necessary concept inclusions, but a lot more. And let me mention here, our approximation scheme is not a one-click solution, but more a guide, so you can make informed decisions when it comes to approximation, which information you can preserve and which not. And it's even interesting to mention that we noticed that our approximation scheme can yield finite approximation in real or for real approximations, for real ontologies in Strongly. So we made a few experiments for real ontologies from the Manchester OWL corpus. And therefore we find that our approximation scheme yields a finite approximation if you think about what you are doing. So you can get rid of all those useless new concept inclusions, sorry. Yeah, so and with this you can find a finite approximation scheme for real ontologies. In the next step, we also expanded our approximation scheme to ELU bottom to EL bottom, so we introduced bottom, and also ALC to EL bottom. And here is not enough time, sadly, to go into much detail for this case, but it's interesting that for this case, it isn't, it doesn't seem like that this approximation yields finite approximations for practical cases. And the only way we find to extend our approximation is by dropping our introduced OS generatability. And the consequence is that our approximations then are infinite unless we are using a depth bound. And I can really recommend you to look in our paper because we have there a few examples, and yeah, this is an even more discussion and the complete approximation scheme, but yeah, not in time here. And the third part is about ontology mediated query, where we all so looked inside and defined an approximation form. And very interesting here is that here we obtain a finite approximation even for the ALC to EL bottom case, as long as we stick to atomic queries. And that was kind of surprising, but nice. And yeah, once again, not enough time here to go into much detail, but you can look in our paper. And I would be happy to discuss with you our results now or later in more detail in our Slack room. So thank you for your attention and questions.